Hey, how are you? Where have you been? I have been looking everywhere for you. If you're playing hide and seek, you are a really good hider. So, way to go. Good job. Today is Wednesday. It's actually June 10th. Can you believe it? We're almost halfway through the month of June. But that means it's summertime. So hopefully you're outside a lot. Maybe you're swimming. Maybe you're going to the beach. You're gonna go see grandparents or go somewhere on a trip. Wherever you are, I'm glad you're with us because we can still sing and dance and learn about Jesus no matter where we are. So, before we get started, show me 10 fingers. Show me 5 fingers. What about 7 fingers? There you go. Good job. Can you show me a happy face? Can you show me a mad face? Show me a scary face. Good job. Show me a sleepy face. Show me a bunny rabbit. Show me a owl. Ooh. Show me a kangaroo. I don't know what a kangaroo looks like. All right, show me your prayer hands. What do those look like? Yeah, mine look like that too. All right, perfect. Let's close our eyes. Ready? I'm gonna help you pray. We're gonna talk to Jesus. Say, dear Jesus, I love you. Thank you for my church. Help me to sing about you and to learn my Bible story. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, we are gonna sing a couple songs. Okay, this first one, we're gonna have to get a little rappy because we're gonna be doing some R to the B. We're gonna R-E-A-D, R-B-I-B-L-E. All right, so stand up, make sure you got room.
I've got to
R-E-A-D. Well, if we were in this game, we want to be on God's side, right? So we're going to sing a song. We're going to say, whose side are you leaning on? Are you eating on? Are you skiing on? Whatever we do, you got to do it with us. All right, here we go.
Said, whose side are you leaning on? I said, whose side are you leaning on?
Skiing on the Lord's side.
I said, whose side are you skiing on?
Too. You're smart for that. Way to go. All right, you know what we need to do? We need to learn a Bible story, and our old friend Ollie, he's always here for us. Let's check out what he's going to teach us today.
Who? Who? Know what time it is?
It's time to hear a story full of wonder. There's so much fun we'll have learning together. So let's go.
Welcome to the clubhouse. It's me, Lucy, and I have the best art project to work on today. But it's super windy outside, and something crazy just happened. The wind blew my circles all over the clubhouse, and now I need you to help me spy them all. Point when you see one. I spy with my little eye a circle that is blue and held by my cuddly friend. Do you see it? Yep, you're good. What should I make with this one? It's blue, like water. Oh, I know. It's the whole world. That was fun. Let's do another one. I spy with my little eye a circle that is brown, and wow, the wind blew it up high. Do you see it? Yes, you got it. Well, actually, this is kind of golden brown, like my favorite food, nice and warm, right out of the oven. It's a pizza. On the count of three, shout out your favorite pizza toppings. One, two, three. Those are so yummy. My favorites are pepperoni and peppers.
Who? Who?
It's Ollie.
Hello, Lucy. Who? Who? Making tasty round treats, are you?
There's so much fun stuff to make with circles.
Crafting with circles is fun, it's true. I know a very special circle, just for you. So let's hear the story. Just follow me through. Who? Who?
Follow me through. Follow me through who? Ollie's got a Bible story for me and you.
Hello, friends. I'm Aisha, and welcome to my cupcake food truck. Do you want to see today's special? Ta-da! They're my whole lot of love cupcakes. I made them because today's story is about someone special who loves us so, so much. If you're ready for a story, on the count of three, yell, tell me a story. One, two, three. Tell me a story. Today's amazing true story is about someone very special who did something only he can do. If you think you know who this very special person is, I want you to shout out his name. Yes, Jesus! Jesus is the very special person, and I'm going to tell you about the most amazing thing he ever did that only he can do. God sent his son, Jesus, to show us how to love each other and to be our friend forever. Wait, where did the heart go? We might need to play I Spy to find it. Get out your pretend binoculars and let's look for it. Ready? Tell me when you see the heart. I spy with my little eye a heart. And look, it's showing us that Jesus taught us how to love others by being a good friend. Wait, where did it go? Let's look for it. Ready? I spy with my little eye the heart right there. Good job, everyone. And look, the heart is showing us that Jesus was a good friend to people who were different than him. Not again. Where did it go now? Let's look for it. Ready? I spy with my little eye the heart. It's showing us that Jesus was a good friend to everyone, even people who made bad choices. Jesus was a friend to everyone. One day, a very sad thing happened. Some angry people took Jesus away and hurt him so bad that he died. Jesus' friends buried him in a tomb and rolled a big stone in front of it. Jesus was gone, and his friends were very, very sad. But on the third day, Jesus did something that only Jesus can do. Jesus came back! Jesus is alive! Yes, Jesus is alive! Say that with me! Jesus is alive! One more time! Jesus is alive! We know Jesus is alive because people saw him and talked with him. Then they wrote all about it so we can know and believe that Jesus is alive! Did you like the story? If you did, give it two thumbs up. Two thumbs up! Oh, hey Ollie, tell me, who can believe in Jesus?
I can believe in Jesus. Yes, it's true. Now let's hear it from you. Tell me, who can believe in Jesus?
I can believe in Jesus. That's the truth, friends. You better believe it. See you next time. Bye.
So there's your story, and it's all true. Jesus is alive, and he's a friend forever to you and me, too.
Thanks, Ollie.
Goodbye to you. Hoo, hoo.
Wow, what a great story. Jesus wants to be a friend to everyone. That means Jesus wants to be my friend, and he wants to be your friend, too. I think I got the story. Did you get it? If you did, say, got it. Get it?
Got it!
Good! I spy with my little eye a circle that is gray and right behind me. I'm going to paint this so it looks just like the stone that was in front of Jesus' tomb. The stone got rolled away because Jesus is alive.
So in our Bible story today, we learned some kind of sad news, right? We learned that there were some people who were so angry that they beat Jesus and they hurt him. In fact, they even killed him, right? That's super sad, isn't it? Because Jesus hadn't done anything wrong, but they mistreated him and he actually died. And when he died, his friends buried him in, what was it again? Yeah, it was a tomb, right? And they put a big rock in front of it and he was inside that tomb for, count with me, 1, 2, 3 days. And then what happened on the third day, huh? You're right, he came back alive. He didn't stay dead. Isn't that incredible? None of us can do that, but Jesus can. And here's the deal. We know that Jesus died and came back alive because people who were around at that time and saw those things happen, they wrote them down in the Bible so that we can read them and know about them. And then we can know and believe about God too. What? Isn't that awesome? Yeah. So let's practice our verse. We've learned it last week, so let me see how well you've been practicing it. All right. Are you ready? Stand up. Okay, here we go. Okay, put your hands like this and say, these are written. These are written. Now point out and say, so that you, point to your head and say, may believe. Now point up and say, that Jesus is the Christ. And now make a baby and say, the Son of God. Now make your Bible hands and say, John 20:31. All right, good job. Let's try it again. Ready? These are written so that you may believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God. John 20:31. All right, try it one more time. These are written so that you may believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God. John 20:31. High five. Way to go. Good job. All right, guys, I have just a couple of quick reminders. These are not new things. These are things that you've already heard me talk about in the last couple weeks, but some of you still need to do it. So pay attention. Here we go. First, I want to see your stuffed animal, your very favoriteest thing. You already saw some really cool photos earlier this week of some of the people's stuffed animals and how cute they are. Look, there's my old teddy bear. Her name is Mammers. Have your mom or dad take a picture and upload it to tinyurl.com/Mrs. April, and I will help share it with all of your friends who are watching too. Second of all, you still have a chance to help us pick out songs to sing on Sundays and Wednesdays. We've had Daniel's help, we've had Isaiah's help. There's some more kids that are gonna be helping in this next week or two. I wanna hear from you. So have your parents help you get onto the Pinedale YouTube page. There is a playlist called Preschool Worship Songs, and there is like 100 songs. You guys know most of them, but sometimes just hearing the name, you might not remember what the song is. So you can listen to them and help remind yourself what they are, and then have your mom or dad send me an email with the things that you would like to sing in the next few weeks, okay? Two more quick reminders. On Sunday morning, we'll have another service for you to watch at home or at the beach or at your grandma's house or maybe you're camping. I don't know where you are, but the cool thing is wherever you are, you can watch it, and not just watch it, you can do it. Make sure you stand up, sing, do the motions, get your mom and dad involved, okay? And also on Wednesdays, same thing. Remember, on Wednesdays, just like today, we get to have a Bible story with Ollie. So make sure you get done with your lessons every Sunday and Wednesday and keep learning about Jesus. All right, one more reminder. You know what it is? Of course you do, you're so smart. Is to do your activities. Super easy. Have your mom or dad click on the link below the video, download the activity page, and work together as a family to do your activities. I love you guys. I hope you have a great rest of your day. Bye.